tread lightly, my friends. There are demons afoot. That's one green moon right there. You heard blue moon? Green moon! I saw you really big in the sky. Green, 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 green moon. Dip to dip to dip, green, 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 green moon. Who lit all these fires? Whoever it was, they were mighty busy. Look how it even... You see above the flame? It's even... You can see the heat. That's pretty awesome. Or it's... Well... It is distort... It's smoke, yeah. But it's distorting... See that? Just distorting the... branch. Pretty sweet. Well, a tree, rather. The chimes of hell. Well, what's gonna come at me and disappear next? Oh, this is a really long tunnel. Chasm. Oh, it's another statue. Oh, and another tent. And I am tall, apparently. Or they were short. Or both. Hello there. Maka Manruad, the only queen to ever have led our great isle, guarding her right to on her crown lean when she was opposed by men of trial. Hunting them into the wilderness of Connacht, they were simple to either enslave or defeat. When debating imperial impact, no, not really, no king shall this Maka beat. What's a Maka? Oh, that Maka Manruad is that Maka. So what's it mean? The queen of the island, guarding her right. She's guarding her right to lead when she was opposed. She hunted him into the wilderness. And she enslaved or defeated them. And she cannot be beaten by any king or man. Sounds like my kind of queen. Kick their butts. Is there any words on this? No. I haven't found any messages for a while. Am I just missing them?
What is happening? I sense sorcery beyond my bent.
Yeah, I stopped moving. Oh, hello?
Bellissima, is this your domain? The Sinach here is indeed akin to your inner fire.
Can't move.
I thank you for reflecting the sortilege and diverting me to this sound shrine away from that malignant murk. How do I retreat back to my hunt after this? Most welcome of respites. Oh, you desire my service to marry the light of the moon with that of the sun?
What?
Accepted. Now, where are the candles?
How do you do that? Make the moon as bright? What? You are watching? Oh, that's nice.
Water.
Can't you see? Well, maybe. Don't I see? Keep searching, okay.
Air.
F- Fear the Reaper? Haha. Don't fear the Reaper, dude. Give you what you want?
Earth.
Did you say use you?
Fire.
Okay. Well, I got all the elements, right? I'm searching. I'm looking. You're spoiled. Give you what you want. What about this thing?
Ether.
Oh, that's the fifth one.
Now, please let these flambeaux abate naturally, as I need not tell you what will befall the seafarers if you do not. Present my finest regards to my father.
Okay.
I met a Taoist master once. He revealed to me that while he had devoted 5 years to the strife of reaching my isles in the hopes of finding his daughter, he had taught himself my language. Moreover, in his own realm, he had been worshipped for his philosophy. But seeing as his lands fell into moral decay, he soon elected to journey westward. I was childless, so I was unskilled in the discussion of his lineage. He did not know, of course, of the true nature of these barbaric hamlets before he arrived.
Hmm. Okay.
Our cultural disparities were soon beheld when he was bedeviled quite heavily by some warriors. At one particular time, he was reportedly surrounded by three heroes who did not want to be converted by his guidance. But when I came by and identified only him, I asked him where they were. He professed that they were now in a greater place, far, far away, beyond these shores.
Did he kill them? Why are they gone?
As a sign of good faith, I blessed him with the ring of Alund the Fortunate to cloak him with the fifth Fiada, a mist of invisibility. In return, he heralded that if I looked for a white angel in the forest of Banager, I would secure sanctity. He then assured me he would spend the next 5 years attempting to uncover his anima anew. We parted to the tunes of the Elysian evening songs until the village ballader's voice gently faded. We searched for her for many moons, but apparently she was no more.
Interesting story. Seraph?
Seraph. So many flowers.
I didn't know you were going to start speaking it.
She sacrificed. Reawaken me. I wish to retrace my trail. One last time.
Okay, I'm gonna retrace the trail. Sweet. Check out that tree though. Oh, I can't go that way? What? Why can't I walk that way? That's not fair. I wonder if I can make my way over there. Doubt it. Oh, I fall down. I can't. No! Alright, I'll stop messing around. For now.
We dashed up the mountain of Boch Lane as fast as we possibly could. Our adventure was coming to an end. I felt it like fire fading from a feast. Looking back, I saw the Lig Nach Phailad sees both warrior and wolf, an angel and a demon reside in all men, even gods, including me. But what truly is of value is which side we feed our innermost wishes and allegiance to. Would the wolf venerate viability in the wilderness, whether willing without worriment? Yet I vow that she wavers betwixt our vocation and her withdrawal.
We vow something. I want to head to yon battlements. I'm gonna stop here and I know. Yep. Where's my wolf friend? Where's animals? So that's what they were talking about before, beasts that weren't animals. Like dragons and whatever the hell those things were. I was a little alarmed by those. Not scared, mind you. I figured that nothing would happen, but just alarmed. Cool. These are the kind of places I really love to explore myself. You'd have to bring a lot of provisions, because it looks like we're very far away from any food or water. Unless you want to start munching on some plants. So I want to meet this wolf he keeps talking about. I feel like we're above the ground now. I want to go there. What's that over there? That is where we can go. Is this a rock or a tree or is it a person? Looks rather big if it's a person. It might just be another... yeah, it looks like it's another statue, actually. That's cool. I like reading those poems. I feel like I'm slightly above all this. Like, we should be... actually feels normal now. Right. All these statues look the same, though. For 7 years, the seer Finnegas had tried to catch the salmon of knowledge in Boyain, when Fionn Fionn Mac Comahal came by to join. He had only grabbed it and had it fried. The young boy was taught not to dine, as the druid hungered for the wisdom for himself. Fionn sucked his thumb, burning the elf. In time, this would be a hero's sign. Grasping that one a little less than the previous one. Wow. Gotta admire the view, that's what I say. Ooh. New theme. Thundering. Oh. Swords. Sweet. That is a very long sword. That's a sword bigger than a ma- yeah, most of these are bigger than me. Yeah, I figure they're also buried somewhat in the ground. Someone decided to get rid of a bunch of swords or something? Because... why? There's another tower. Oh, what we got over here? Something interesting? With a bird? We actually have another living thing. That's a big bird. Oh! For some reason that stalled me. Okay. Cool. Bridge. Bridge over troubled hillocks.
Seraph, is that you? Yes. Now I recall the event that befell my peak. Mugruith returned as a deer and had apparently first assumed the form of a salmon to withstand the river.
Wow.
She conjured thunderstorms to perplex our defarmers and even turned some of the werewolves to stone.
She can do all that?
It was Draiochta who bequeathed my world the ultimate sacrifice. She put 12 of her flowers down on the ground and began to choir the most comely of songs.
A wolf that sings and does things with flowers. Oh wow. The great arch looms ahead. So this mug returned as a salmon and then a deer and... So wait. He's a god. He's referring to himself as a god and he's talking about other gods. Apparently.
Strange.
Oh.
I suddenly sense an abrupt yen to reminisce about the ceremony. I, in like manner,
Hello?
As my heroine, harvesting 12 flowers and resting them on one of the blood-soaked amphoras the zealots had hauled up the crags.
One flower. That does not look very friendly. You just stay where you are. I need to collect some flowers. I'm gonna go this way. Four flowers? What'd he say? I have to get 8? Is that what he said? Okay, it's more. Still facing my way? Not sure. Kinda looks like he is. So I guess we get the 8 flowers. And then we head for Grim Reaper thing. What if we head for Grim Reaper thing first? Are there 2 endings? 2 possible endings? Seven? Someone over here. 8. Or maybe a dozen. I forget what he said. You look quite intimidating. It's like it has, it used to have wings, but it's now just bones. So yeah, I'm using the WASD keys now. Is there another one before? Maybe I'm supposed to get a dozen. Oh, I see one over there. Too bad I can't sprint. There's no sprint. Only T-Bubble. Hmm. Yeah, he is turning to face me. Oops. And probably laughing at me because I'm crashing into stuff while watching him turn to face me. Oh my. (laughs) I'm not getting that close to him. I'm going to make sure I get every flower possible. So it is a dozen. There's the last one. I'm assuming. Watch it suddenly turn into Dark Souls here. Greetings. Hail. Oh, good. I live on. I live another day. I have defeated the Grim Reaper. She said that. Don't fear the Reaper. Ah, yes. Play my military tune of righteousness and victory. Crags and rocks and hills.
Apparently, she was versed in Krumkroak's affinity with the Zodiac and his fear of the Quabade. This beckoned the sun to come forth and reshape all the Hellions into men once more. Krumkroak and Cloydha were also erased. For little did they know that Draiochta had sub rosa placed a geyser of light upon them by the river. However, the ensorcelled Hellion of Draiochta's trance hurled Mug away, so she struck a boulder and blacked out. Draiochta herself was sent flying over the ledge of the mountain, and I too was deprived of existence.
Was, so we exist again, now, somehow. I guess that was a temporary thing. So the wolf was sent flying, I guess we go this way. Where was the wolf flew to? Is the wolf still there? Is the wolf alive? Will we find the answer? Will we find out? Well, that's the sun. Wow. Another statue. Kulain, however you say it, was cursed with geese's aplenty. Never should he eat dog meat, nor heart refused. So when three hags offered him these to use, Ku had no choice but to be friendly. Crippled by Coven, his assassin struck, all but bested, the savior wed himself to a pole. The Raven Morrigan entrusted Q one last role to rise as legend for all who quest after luck. Are we questing after luck? Do we want luck? And luck seems like a good thing to have. Luckily, I existed again. Yay!
In such wise must I cast my verdict? Is this true, Seraph? Permitted, the left path will reunite me with Mug, yet let my heavenly might remain expelled till death do us part, and the right shall adorn me with a chance to reform and join Draiochta in Terranuk? Granted. Gift me a stage to vote, my guardian.
Okay, one... I forget which one was one. Which one? Which one? We get reunited with Mug, but apparently we lose our godly powers. And the other way, we reform, I think, as a god. This is, if I'm reading this right. And reunited with the wolf, Draiochta, I think, is the name. So I guess up ahead we'll have to choose left or right. Cool. Gnarled tree of gnarliness. So who would think the flowers would defeat the Grim Reaper thing? I guess life defeats death. You'd think it would only be the other way around, right? It looks like roots above the tree. Oh, the music suddenly stopped. Okay, I guess we're going this way.
Do not seek the opulent riches of the gods, nor the tainted virtues of the mortals anymore.
Aww.
It is better to die for your values than live as another. And so I wish, now, to become what I am.
Oh, did I choose? I didn't realize you can go another way. Could you? Huh. Well, there's that Tonguç, I don't know how to say that name. VoiceBunny.com? Did the voiceover? Huh. Interesting. Assortment of swords. You're welcome for playing. The hunting god uses Unreal, right? Unreal 4. Huh. Oh, wait. There's more? Oh, these are the chapters. These are the chapters. Okay, Earth is the first chapter, right? We have four chapters. Okay. I'm gonna choose another way to go. I'm gonna see what happens. I didn't realize there was a different way. So, yeah. I guess I'll play this whole part over again. Okay, I just got that audio cue telling me right, I'm guessing, is that way that I went, which is Draiochta the Wolf. If we go this way, we are reunited with Mug, I believe? Or is it not yet? It says to the left. I'm trying to stick to the left, or maybe it's after this tree. I'm guessing I go that way. Oh, that's okay. Now I see. That might even be the wolf sitting there. I'm not sure. Right, we turned at this tree. I get it. It wasn't back there. But it looks like this is another drop-off, but nope. Okay, that's what confused me. We can't continue on this way. So we have to meet Mug. Wherever the hell Mug is. Oh, that's a bird. So the left-hand path. We lose our godly powers. At least, I think. That's what I understand. Looking forward to see who or what Mug is. Mug is another god, I believe. Mug something. Yo, Mug. I don't see any Mug.
What is the worth of life if devoid of love?
Oh, that's Mug.
Let us pray, you and I, that the gods will show us grace.
Aw. Haha. So what do you guys think? Interesting, huh? Interesting game. Thanks so much for watching. Hope to see you in another Let's Play. I plan on playing more of his games. You know, a bit at a time. So, stay tuned for more games. And always, seek adventure.